Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in North Carolina. I have an important word that the Lord gave me for Israel. If you guys watch my videos, you know that most of the things I hear from the Lord are about, for the church, particularly for the church or the coming Antichrist and things like that, as the Lord would give me. But the Lord gave me a dream, specifically a message for the nation of Israel. Now, I know that, most in Israel do not believe in Yeshua as the Messiah. But of course, there are many rabbis who believe that maybe he's the Messiah for the Gentiles. I've heard lots of rabbis say that, but he's not their Messiah. So there's varying degrees on that. But in the Word of God from Joel chapter 2, in the Tanakh, the Old Testament, the prophet Joel tells us in the last days, God would pour out his Spirit on all flesh. He didn't say just the nation of Israel, but on all flesh. And old men would dream dreams, and young men would prophesy, see visions, and your sons and daughters would prophesy. And so, in line with the Word of God, brothers and sisters, and by the Spirit of the Most High God, the Ruach Elohim is the Hebrew name for the breath of God, the Lord had given me a dream that's specifically and clearly for the nation of Israel. So, and the Lord told me over and over and over again in my dream, the voice of the Lord. As a matter of fact, the Lord is just pressing my spirit. It was a voice of an angel, a messenger from God, who was telling me, brothers and sisters, that just as what happened in 1948, this is what happened in 1967. We're going to see a similar thing again. And what happened at that time? Israel was attacked from many sides by its enemies. Now there's all these people who get caught up in all these debates and saying there's a war in Psalm 83, which I don't see a war in Psalm 83. It's not written in the text at all. But it's not the point. All we've already had, Israel has already been attacked. 1948, 1967, 1973, 1956. There's also a war at the Suez Canal. So there's been four or five already times that Israel has got into a war with its neighbors. So, instead of, for you Gentiles who are watching this, who think you're Jews and you're not, we don't always try to say, oh, and get into all this about the Bible prophecy being fulfilled, and everything that happens is a Bible prophecy fulfilled specifically, and all of these things. The Lord didn't call us to do that, to nitpick and try to look at what Bible prophecy fulfilled and try to calculate the return of the Lord and all these things that many people are trying to do that God didn't call us to do. And that's the problem. As you guys know, if you watch my video on YouTube, there's people who make a video every day saying that it's the fulfillment of Bible prophecy, obviously for attention and for attention from viewers. And brothers and sisters, these things ought not be. So the Lord gave me a word and a text, a Bible text, Psalm 47. And the Lord kept repeating that to me. An angel from the Lord kept repeating to me, do not forget that it's Psalm 47. And the Lord said that just like what, and the angel was saying to me as a messenger from the Lord, that just as in 1948 and just like in 1967, that all of these, the enemies of Israel would come at her just like it did in those days. Okay, brothers and sisters. Now, as I mentioned, I want to tie this in and say it again. Israel has been attacked many times in the past, but that was not the end. The end was not yet, brothers and sisters. Every time a rocket fires from the Golan Heights or from Gaza and all these places, it doesn't mean that, oh, the tribulation has begun tomorrow. It's been happening, and Israel's been under attack since the day they pronounced themselves a nation. As soon as they pronounced themselves a nation, under Ben Gurion, as the nation of Israel, there on May 14th, on the Gregorian or whatever it is, the calendar that the Western nations use, they were immediately attacked by five nations, and they've been under attack since 1948. So there's nothing new about that, brothers and sisters. This has been going on. But the word that the Lord gave me for the nation of Israel is this from Psalm 47. Oh, clap your hands, all ye people! Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Now that's always good. And there's songs in the Gentile church, Christian churches, we have songs from, lots of the songs in your Pentecostal churches come from the Psalms. So that's why. And these songs, these used to be sung, and they are sang by the Israelites. Oh, clap your hands, all ye people, shout unto God with the voice of triumph. For the Lord Most High is terrible, in the King James, or awesome, or great, mighty. He is a great king over all the earth. He shall subdue the people under us and the nations under our feet. He's talking about Israel. He shall choose our inheritance for us. So God is the one who picks what land belongs to Israel. And that's the message. I'm going to tell this video, even though I've been talking to all of these Gentiles who are in error, as the Lord has led me by His Spirit. And all those people that tried to divide the land of Israel, as it tells us, the reason why God sends all the nations into the valley of Jehoshaphat or into the valley of judgment is because they divided my land, God says, my land. So the land of Israel is God's land, and for all those who try to divide it, even the prime minister of Israel, and of course I don't know that he would ever see this video, by the grace of God, and I think he knows this better than the former prime minister, Ariel Sharon, who before he had his stroke, he told his rabbinical advisor, when he told, you know, the rabbinical advisor told him, hey, you're not supposed to give away this land, you know, that you don't have that authority. He said, I don't care what the Bible says, you know, I'm trying to work this out. And then after that, he had his stroke. So I believe that the leaders of Israel now know better than doing that. So by the grace of God, they will know that they do not have the authority, even the prime minister of Israel and all his cabinets and Ariel Sharon and all those guys and Shimon Peres, no one from the throne of God, God Elyon, the God Most High, El Shaddai, God Almighty, he has not given any man the authority to divide his land. The only one who ever divided the land amongst the tribes was Moses under the direction from God. Anyway, brothers and sisters, and then Joshua did some also. Let's see. For he, verse 4, he shall choose our inheritance for us. God is the one who says what land belongs to Israel and what doesn't. And he divides it among the tribes as he wills. And the excellency of Jacob whom he loved. Selah, pause. That Selah means pause. He is gone up with a shout. Now this part reminds me of the catching away of the church from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16. And when Moses went up to receive the Ten Commandments on the mount, God is gone up with a shout, the Lord with the sound of a trumpet. It reminds me, and in my spirit, of the catching away of the church, the rapture of the church. Verse 5, God is gone up with a shout, the Lord with the sound of a trumpet. Sing praises to God, sing praises unto our King, sing praises. For God is the King of all the earth, sing ye praises with understanding. God reigneth over the heathen, that's the Goyim, the nations. God setteth upon the throne of his holiness. The princes of the people are gathered together, even the people of the God of Abraham. For the shield of the earth belongeth unto God. He is greatly exalted. So God is the one, number one, for the nation of Israel. The message is God's going to deliver Israel. God sets the boundaries of Israel. Man doesn't, even the leaders of Israel, or even Obama, or any other derelict, a loser puppet on a string that Satan puts in charge of the United States, that God allows Satan's people in control of all these countries, as Satan told Yeshua in the Gospels when he tempted Yeshua in the desert. He said, if I will give you all the kingdoms of the earth because it's in my power to do so, if you'll bow down and worship me. So even though God is ultimately in charge, you know, every country has all this corruption. Why? Because you got to sell your soul to be in charge of a country, almost in every nation. You know, and that's why it says that righteousness exalts a nation. We've had a few righteous leaders. Israel has had, if you read the book of Kings, 1 and 2 Samuel, Chronicles, 1 and 2 Chronicles, you'll see that Israel, or particularly the tribe of Judah, had some righteous kings and some unrighteous kings, some evil kings who were under the influence of Satan. Brothers and sisters, thank God that God put Netanyahu in, even though Netanyahu is not a very practicing religious man. He's the man that God chose for this hour to say no, to just say no to the devil's plan until God's timing. But listen, brothers and sisters, there's a time coming, no matter who's the prime minister of Israel, particularly even at this time Netanyahu, where God's timing will make a deal with the son of perdition, the son of destruction. Apollonia in the Greek. that child of the devil, that Judas of Israel and the world, the Antichrist, who will bring in the one world, new world order in the name of peace and divide the land of God, the nation of Israel. That's coming. But in the meantime, the word I gave you is a promise of God that he will be the one to defend Israel. He's the shield over Israel. He will protect Israel from anything that's going on until those times in the end times, in the tribulation period, the time of Jacob's trouble, the 70th week of Daniel, that seven-year period we call the tribulation period in the world of the nations, the Gentile church. That time is coming. But until then, God is going to deliver Israel. He who guards over Israel neither slumbers nor sleeps. And that day is now, brothers and sisters. God will protect Israel from this coming attack. And it's also the timing that the church, as it says there in verse 5, that God is gone up with a shout and the Lord with the sound of a trumpet. Brothers and sisters, that's us. We're going to be out of here. The Gentile church, we'll be out of here. Or, you know, all people that are born again. They're also Messianic Jews, brothers and sisters. But, of course, the vast majority of the body of Christ is Gentiles. Just as the Lord said, it's the time of the Gentiles, and the time of the Gentiles will be fulfilled. And then the Lord will once again will choose Jerusalem. And that's what he's doing, brothers and sisters. We are in a process since the 1800s, really, of a transition from the church age to the 70th week of Daniel. And ultimately, that 70th week of Daniel that people love to keep talking about, the tribulation, is only a birth pains for the birth of the return of the Messiah. And for Israelites, you know, they're looking for, they don't know who the Messiah is. They're looking for the Messiah to come. But at the end of that seven-year period, the Messiah will return. And it says in Zechariah chapter 12, verse 10, they will mourn for the one they pierced. And in Zechariah chapter 14, the prophet Zechariah said, they will say, where did you receive these wounds? And he'll say, I received them in the house of my brethren. That is Yeshua, HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah, Jesus the Christ, the anointed one of God, the Son of God. He will return to Israel at the end of that seven-year tribulation, brothers and sisters. And we, born-again Christians who go in the rapture and those who die during the tribulation, we will return with the Lord. As Enoch, seventh from Adam, said, he will return with 10,000s of his saints. And we'll be back with the Lord Jesus Christ at the end of that tribulation. But in the meantime, brothers and sisters, the word that the Lord gave me is just like in 1948, just like in 1967, Israel will be attacked again, but God is with Israel, and God will deliver Israel. So God bless, brothers and sisters. Look up, our redemption draweth nigh. As we see these things come to pass, behold, look up and know that your redemption draweth nigh.